intelligent solutions in banks. Problem definition. And as you know, business intelligence concept is around for quite a while. It's kind of successor of decision support systems and so, but there are still unsolved problems. It's hard to define requirements for business intelligence solutions. It's hard to measure success. And in many cases, it's hard to achieve perceived success, really. So, these were concepts I was trying to address. And what about my motivation? Basically, I'm in my current work, I'm involved in these business intelligence related activities lately. I was able to attend business intelligence related courses and also business analysis related courses. I will explain later on. And this program, of course, is also about business analysis in many ways. And also in my work, I'm very connected with different banks and this finance sector. So, to put it all together, this is the result. So, okay, and a brief introduction to about banking in Latvia, some statistics. As you can see, these volumes are increasing. 15 years ago, there were hardly some POS terminals, just a few internet bank users, and its situation is changing rapidly. And it's not only trends in Latvia, it's of course all around the world. There's a steady increase, and it's a logical result that when you have more and more data and you want to make sense of it, you need to have some sort of solution for it. And there is this well-known quote that answer lies in my data, but well, I just cannot dig it up. So that was what I was investigating. And the research goal, basically, the goal was to develop feasibility assessment approach. Well, my aim was not to develop some sort of full-fledged method for implementation or for design. I focused on first step on feasibility assessment, how to choose the right solution, how to not go wrong in this crucial part. And then second was to develop some guidelines for business analysts who are involved in similar activities, so they can actually use my thesis to perform these tasks better. So research approach, so those are my goals which I stated previously. And in order to get there, I'm using five major inputs. Scientific inputs would be research of literature, prototyping and interviews, and other important inputs are expert suggestions, business intelligence expert suggestions, and some information from job which is classified, but well, I cannot really avoid using my knowledge in some degree. And then I used Babok guide. Babok is its body of knowledge. It's, I will tell you next slide, basically this framework, this body of knowledge gave overall structure for thesis, and then I was able to work on feasibility assessment and extended some study done by RTU doctorate, and I will tell about that later on. So, very briefly about Babok. So it's a guide to business analysis body of knowledge, and it's globally recognized. It's basically, it's product of practitioners, but also widely used in academic environment. And a very important point that this Baba guide does not prescribe process or order for tasks. It's just, it gives this body of knowledge. And here you can see these areas that are considered in this guide. And these gray background are the ones which I researched and examined in details in my study. So, solution assessment, I was not able to do it. There was no actual solution at the end. And requirements management, communication, it's not so important because, well, it is important, but this requirements analysis, elicitation, and enterprise analysis, they are key areas. So I started with doing enterprise analysis, and what I was trying to do, I was trying to examine the definition of business need, solution approach, definition and definition of solution scope. For business case, I just assumed that bank can justify implementation of such a solution, and of course I was not able to access any capability gaps. So business need definition started with interviews of bank employees. They are anonymous because, well, this information is sensitive and no financial institution want to give it away, what kind of systems we are using, what kind of technologies we are using. But then I was just able to contact four employees, in some cases ex-employees, and get really important information. As we can see here, that name software used by bank, it's quite similar. In some cases, there are different. Also, consumers of data warehouse, it's very similar. But there are differences in personnel involved. Because few of these banks, as you can see, they are using external consultants, off-the-shelf solutions, but some have quite big teams, like 10 employees just for warehousing. So using these interviews, I was able to shape the business need of like a generic construct of Latvian banks. So they need to provide data for business analysts, for product managers, for regulatory institutions. It can be extracted from this. Of course, and full interviews are included in thesis and appendix. Of course, I cannot cover all the process, so I will just continue with summary for guidelines for anyone who is doing a particular task. So different frameworks need to be considered. Babok will be just a cliff of iceberg, will just give a body of knowledge. A solution dilemma must be approached creatively for some small organization, beginning banks in some developing countries. They might even not need a business intelligence solution. Excel files, some extracts might just be enough. So in order, when we talk about final decision and comparison of solutions, then some framework must, it's recommended to use some sort of method, and I will go into details later. And scope creep, it's important to use some sort of iterative approach. It can be very easily extracted from practitioners' guides, from scientific literature. It's impossible to define 100% of requirements straight away. Okay, next area is elicitation. We'll just continue with it because we might run out of time. And those are elicitation techniques offered by Babok. I tried to justify them using scientific literature and some BI expert experience, because Babok gave just the general guidelines and techniques, but I'm considering business intelligence solutions and banks. And the result was